This is part three of a series, and I'm talking about possibilities within the Voynich Manuscript. And somebody has said that there's not enough one or two letter words within the manuscript to make it a legit language. And I already argued against that. I'd also like to add that, you know, I have to draw from my experience in Arabic. There are words that are very short, however they combine with the word in front of it, and it appears to be one word, but it's not, it's actually two. And just for an example, bit is with, so bit aman is with hope, and li means for. You combine it with liha, and it means for her. And you see, that's just one possibility how things can get hidden. And I'd like to comment on these letters. In Arabic, you can have a letter at the beginning of a word, and in the middle it looks completely different, and again it looks completely different at the end of a word. And I don't think that's unique to Arabic. So, I noticed this letter is always at the start of a word in this Voynich manuscript. And then I'm thinking that maybe that is related to this, because you kind of have that same symbol. And I noticed that this letter is always at the end of a word. And so I'm thinking that maybe this is just one possibility where just one letter changes throughout the word. And a similarity to this would be the sigma letter in Greek. At the same time, I do think that maybe these letters are like ligatures where to save room, they combine two letters. This happens in Arabic. This is a ligature in Arabic. It's la. That's actually two letters. And I'd like to point out on page 66 in that middle column, also you'll see these as separate letters, but it seems to indicate that they're different. Like this flourish is a completely different letter than this, and this, because of that flourish missing there, that's also a different letter. And here's an example of how drastically letters can change. In Arabic, this is K, kutub, for books. This is halak, which means kosher. And K, this is K. You can see how different they are from the beginning to the end of a letter. And you see, going on to part four, I'll get into whole words and what I think they may mean.